Hello all, and welcome to episode 42 of Enterprise Tech India Unplugged. And we hope you are subscribing to our YouTube channel, to our podcast in audio format. We would wish that you would listen to us in the audio format, because as you can see, we are not great looking people. So and we don't always spend time on doing great lighting and makeup. So listen to us and enjoy the conversation. We do it completely unscripted. We do not give notes to our participants. They come and speak their mind. Today we have Kumaran, who is the chief mentor and CTO for Tiny Magic. And we have Nishant, who is an architect with IBS Software. And Venkat, who is head of technology for Aqua Connect. And the topic we have is a provocative one, because it is traditional wisdom now to make fun of waterfall and deride it and say bad things about waterfall. But today what we are going to explore is why waterfall still makes sense in the world today, and is it something which we can still get benefit out of, and should we throw the baby with the bathwater, as they say? Starting with you, Kumaran, do you think waterfall still has some value to doing projects, either in the software IT industry or in general?
So let's just kind of just take a step back. Like, what does waterfall actually mean? You understand the requirement, you do a design, you do a development, you do an integrated testing, and you do a modeling. This will be there even if I'm going to write a hello world. Waterfall will exist. So I don't think waterfall will ever go away. In that way, waterfall will. Now, the thing is, do I need to have a small waterfall or a Niagara Falls? That's the only debate.
Okay. So what you're saying is that even when you're doing agile, you're doing small waterfalls.
Correct.
So Venkat, your view of how you have been doing in your startup, how you have been working on projects.
Just to kind of say, right, a lot of companies are still doing waterfall only with Agile. Mm-hmm. What does that mean? It's a 1 year project. The final release will be after 1 year only. Mm-hmm. Okay, they call it Agile because they move all the software to the integration test server.
Okay.
With CI/CD.
Okay.
Okay, and they call we are Agile. No. Okay, so there are still many projects out there. I would roughly put a number more than around 50 to 60% of the projects are still doing waterfall only. Mm-hmm. Okay, till the integration server, or it may be user kind of end user testing, it can have an agile. But true agile is only if it goes production. And I think 50 to 60% of the projects don't do that. They don't go production. So that way, waterfall is very much alive.
Okay. So Venkat, your experience.
Yeah. So after listening to the Kumaran, I think we thought of we are following the agile, but it is not. It is waterfall we are still following internally. So.
In fact, Venkat, your bank bazaar is a classical example. The bazaar thing is a classical waterfall project that you executed.
I totally agree with you. Yeah, that is true. So,
don't worry, waterfall is very healthy and alive. Nobody is going to
talk. Okay. I'm happy to hear that this is what the real story is, because everywhere you go and say the word waterfall, people look at you very weird. And think, where has this guy come from? He says, we are agile. Who talks about waterfall these days?
Before you give to Nishant, right, there's one funny thing about this word, right? So instead of waterfall and a phase, we will call it agile and iteration. That's all. Replace modules and phases with iteration, and you are done.
Yes, and change the WBS to user stories.
Yeah, it's just that you don't. It's interesting that you don't. I mean, like, you can't understand Tamil. There's a channel called Certified Rascals. Okay, mm-hmm. So there was one episode, and the episode was called Opportunities. So the team meeting will start by telling, I have this problem, I have that problem. So then the project manager will say, okay, guys, let me tell you something. Don't use the word problem, say opportunity. So don't say I have a problem with the application. Don't say I have a problem with performance. Say I have an opportunity. Then one guy will be sitting, listening. Finally, he'll say, sir, I have a very good I think I have a very deep alcohol opportunity. I drink every day.
Change the problem to the opportunity. Okay.
Nishant.
Nishant, what is your experience?
Yeah, I also agree with what Kuman said. Like, it's like old wine in new bottle. In this Agile also, actually, still we are following the waterfall, but small waterfalls, like, and we could actually reduce the gap between each phase. That is a major thing. And we could actually solve the major communication gap between each stakeholders. Mm-hmm. These two are the major problems, actually, we could address with this Agile, but still all the things that we used to follow in the waterfall still there in the Agile model.
Okay.
So Nishant, a question, right? In your, from what you have seen, what is the best iteration time where to go, and what is the longest? What is the shortest you have seen, and what is the longest? Like, for example, by in principle, in Tiny Magic, our thing is 1 week. We should go production in 1 week. Okay. Worst case, I have had one thing which has been sleeping for 1 year. Literally, no, not even 1 year, 18 months.
But that sleeping means there's no work being done on it, right?
No, there was work being done. But okay. Then it was like, I'm building this module, this needs that, so I'm building that, that needs that. This. It didn't go production at all. And I'm saying it didn't go production. There were some demos shown to me, some demos shown to Sukumar like that. But it did not go. So the worst case was around 18 months, right? But our goal we set out is like 1 week. But on average, I would say in 2 weeks is what our phase is. So best case is like 1 week. We have had things like that planned, get released in 1 week. Worst case, 18 months things have held. But roughly it takes around 2 weeks is what is happening if I look at the average over the period of 4-5 years. How has it been for you, Nish?
I think there also it depends on that overall complexity of the underlying product. So like that also, if you work in a product, actually the sprint cycle also is actually linked to the complexity of something. Like, is it really feasible to at least slice a story or create a story which can be delivered in a 1 week time frame? But most of the case, even in our case, actually it is a 2 week sprint, but even the 2 week sprint itself actually, what we generally notice, like we can see so many spillovers, like it will spill out to the next sprint and also. And even though the sprint is 2 weeks, they generally that reach the production in a 1 month time. So what I believe is like, that depends on the complexity of the product. Like if we could say, if the product complexity is, especially in a monolithic case, I think 1 week, I don't think 1 week or 2 week also may not be possible. So that purely depends on the nature of
one. Yeah. You're telling like fairly 1 month is something which you can see that it is like in a true agile.
Achievable. Yeah, true. Correct.
So 1 month waterfall, Deepak. I think we will compromise. Not for you, not for me. 1 month waterfall. Okay.
I think we have concluded that waterfall is not dead. Waterfall is very much alive. And people are doing waterfall even when they say they are doing agile. But let us look at it from where do you think that actually waterfall really makes sense? Where we should not even pretend to do agile, right? Where does it make sense to say, let us just do waterfall. Let us forget about all these agile.
No, I think So I think if we kind of take from what we have been discussing, are you talking about a large waterfall, like 1 year waterfall? Because
Maybe a large waterfall is where you will say, yes, this project, it makes sense for us to simply do waterfall.
no, I mean, see, I think every use case is a waterfall, okay? So I think what we are probably debating on is it a 3 month waterfall? Is it Has something got to be a 6 month waterfall? Okay. Or 3 month, I'm okay. But I don't see, I cannot imagine a 6 month or a waterfall 6 months or above. I don't see a need for that. If somebody can tell me, you know, there is no way nothing can go production in 6 months, I would love to see that and understand that case. As far as in all the experience that I have had, I cannot imagine anything like that.
So what you're suggesting is that a longer than 6 months waterfall will basically meet not will not meet the project goals
Yeah,
at all.
and I think probably, of course, I might have a confirmation bias. For example, let me tell you something. Like there was this case which I said, like MVPs, right? It's about MVP, no? So there was this case where somebody said brain surgery has to be done. Okay, you have to get into the brain and get that. Well, how can you do an MVP of that?
There is no
Cut
MVP.
half the brain and then look at it.
Yes.
Well, actually, an MVP was done. In the digital world, it is done. And that kind of blew my mind. And I kind of got convinced that there's nothing which cannot be done with an MVP. What they did is, I think Nishant might have seen that video. I think during that program, I had kind of forwarded, if I get it, I'll put it into our group. They actually did a scan of the brain, the entire tumor came. They did a 3D printout of the brain and the skull. And the doctors could do the operation 3 times before they actually touched the real skull.
Right.
That is an MVP. So if you can do MVP for a brain surgery, for a typical IT project, somebody has to really fight tooth and nail to convince me that you have to do a 6 month waterfall or more.
No, I think the MVP itself is not really breaking the mold of a waterfall or agile, right?
No, it is not. It is not. An MVP will come out at the end of a waterfall. So either you have a 2 week MVP or a 1 month MVP kind of a thing, right? Which means at the end of a waterfall, you'll end up with an MVP.
So actually, I'll tell you the reason why some of these things came to my mind as to why waterfall should be still considered as a viable approach to do things. Because I was looking at so ITIL came up with their own new version about 2 years ago, not 2019, something like that. Right. So they have included a lot of the industry things because ITIL was created some in 2011 when Agile was not that big deal, etc. All those things. So what came across was that they are suggesting that although because ITIL is completely focused on IT, and they're saying waterfall is very much a approach which we have to understand and acknowledge that it exists and people will use it. People just need to understand what are the pros and cons for both waterfall and agile, and they can choose the right method for the right scenario, right? So one of the things which they said was waterfall works with when you have a clear go live date, right? So this date is there, you must go live on that day, right? And there's a predictable phases are there, and the business, you don't have to keep on doing business case justification and co value creation, all those things. Those things are sort of well defined in advance, right? And cost is allocated, is fixed, right? It's like building a bridge, right? It's like building a bridge. So you have to build a bridge. The dimensions are known. The amount of cement you have to put, amount of all those things are there. These are very fixed quantities, right? Maybe the prices change a little bit here and there, but that is just a cost part of it. But the project itself is completely waterfall, right? And lot of people have done the same thing over and over again. They know exactly what phases work. They know what stage, what should be done. It's like a factory, right? In a factory, there's no MVP, right? When the, on the, in the if you're an assembly line always goes the same way. They know exactly at what time. It is predictable, right? So there, where you have this all is predictable and there is time go live is fixed, right? Where the requirements cannot be compromised or changed, right? Those are the places where you should consider that what is the point doing agile here, right? Besides breaking those things into smaller parts and say every 2 weeks we will check the progress, etc., etc. But the same thing can be done with a checklist, right? Checklist of what is completed, what is not, the whole work breakdown structure as per the whole waterfall model.
I'm still not able to imagine a real life use case. Maybe that will kind of make me think or convinced, but this information is not enough for me to change my mind or not even consider it.
Okay. So yeah, of course, means anyway, we agreed that even when we do this small time.
And I'll tell you why I'm telling that, right? Uh-huh. Even if your requirements are clear, mm-hmm. okay, it is never clear how many buttons you want to have on the screen.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Is the user comfortable with a mobile interface or with a text interface? Okay, all this data is not, I don't think at a requirements level, people would have got that thing.
Mm-hmm.
Usability and adoptability is something which an MVP reveals. Right. I don't think it's possible for any person to kind of say this user interface, like end users.
I think maybe we need to define where, in which situations, of course, software, we now understand that waterfall may not be, even though we do it that way, but it makes sense for us to be agile and be adaptive and things like what you mentioned about that. But
so in a conventional thing, bridge example, right?
Yeah.
I cannot do half a bridge and say, okay, it's production ready, go halfway exactly. and jump exactly. from there and swim across the river.
Exactly. Exactly. So what I meant to say is there are certain things in IT, maybe not necessarily building software, like maybe setting up a call center, setting up network infrastructure, right? The there are whole associated things around software which still have to go with the waterfall model.
That's right? True. That's because correct. Yeah.
You need predictability. Even if you need to deploy software into the data center, let's say you do not go to the cloud, you need predictability when the servers are going to be available, when how it is going to be network is going to be deployed. All those are just linear method. There is no MVP for that. This is if you need a requirement.
That I would agree. Yeah. Like, let's say call center, what you just said, right? If you take the whole thing, then like even if one person has to receive a call, they even if it's just one person receiving a call from one customer, it needs to go through audit, backup, compliance. All those systems have been there even to receive one phone call.
Right. Yes. Right.
That's true. If we have clear predictability and end goal is pretty clear, then what for in that scenario is what for? Yeah, that's true.
But what I'm getting from all of you is that it is not possible to do it in software. It's because people change their mind and the user interface is fluid and people just don't agree.
Bridge analogy, right? After you build the bridge, somebody says, you know what? I don't like those three columns there. Can you change it from string bridge to arc bridge? We'll go build another bridge. We can't change this bridge. So my friend keeps joking, right? You bought a TV. You go to that Samsung and they say, you know, I don't like the button in that right corner. It's too hard for me in my house. Can you change the button to the top left corner so that I can press the switch on there? I say, get lost. You want the TV? Take it. Otherwise, no, I cannot change the button for your need.
As you rightly said, the main difference between waterfall and agile is, see, in the waterfall, you never change your requirements, right? So once you have freeze the requirements for 6 months, that's it. You can change it in the middle. And you can also see the output also. See, we thought that, okay, that output will be line. But when we see the output, In their perspective, it might be a lion. For in our perspective, it might be a dog.
No. It's the other way around, Deepak. Software developers think we make lions, but the end user see monkeys there.
Hey, actually, I was saying the same actually. Okay. So I was saying in the end user's perspective.
Okay. Yeah.
And user is seeing it only as a from their perspective because the software there's no agreement between. But okay, so this
and one more point is in our classic examples, we think that customer will like this feature, just implement it. Until unless you tested it with the real-time customer, you will know whether he will like it or not. Because as your example, you to cross the river, you just build a bridge, but they don't have a vehicle. Right, so how they will cross the bridge? They have a in Tamil we call it ipdi povangale adhu per enna sir
boat ora
ore chinna boat irukku adha okkandittu kaiyila thallittu povangale
the small boat
that round boat
Arisal.
If you want to help that customer, just if you tie a rope from one end to other end, they will cross it very easily.
Yes.
Right? You don't need to build a bridge, right? So first you need to, that's where the so-called agile will comes in. So in the 2 weeks, you just deploy it, whether how you see how the user is using it. Then you know that, okay, in this case, bridge is not enough. Just tie a rope from here and then there, and they will cross it very easily.
So what you're saying is, when the requirements are not clear or there may be changes, rapid changes may be happening, it is better to go with the agile approach where you are not committing to anything.
So in our company, we never, the requirement is never fixed actually. I worked with the 10 projects and from my past company as well. In the 10 projects when we started developing the product, the end product is completely different. So that's where I think so-called agile will help us to reduce the all the effort, right, where we are putting it, where we are wasting.
So I think this is the reason why actually Agile exists in the first place, because the people who wrote the Agile manifesto, they realized this is what is happening in real life, and this is whatever we are doing is not helping, and the very fact that software enables you to do these changes rapidly and you cannot do the same thing bridges, so that is what makes Agile more feasible for software projects where it's lines of code versus millions of tons of cement and concrete, right? So I think as a context, waterfall still makes sense. But as you just explained, that for software industry, waterfall should not be even considered as a most viable approach for any purpose, because no matter how good we make sure that the requirements are frozen, unless people see it, feel it, they will change their mind. And the very fact that people believe that it is possible for you to change rapidly, they are going to make that demand, isn't it? Let's say if software was like the bridge, you cannot change it. Once it is there, it is there. People would have accepted it, isn't it? If it was not so easy to change software, if the computers were not fast enough for me to compile in seconds and deploy on the cloud in minutes, I would have not said, okay, I know it is difficult to do. Let me try and reduce my expectation of rapid change, right? Any comments about that, Kumar?
I think it's hard.
It was the case before, actually.
I think we never, okay, it's hard for me to imagine because we never faced that, no? It's like a thing we've never there, so.
Yeah. So I think it is because of the nature of the industry. I think and I think people should think about this from when they try to apply Agile in different scenarios. Because now I keep hearing they want to do Agile in HR, right? They want to do Agile in, they want to do Scrum in sales, right? And this is being done. Right, this is being done. This is not. I'm not just making it up. Right, people want to do Scrum in HR. People want to do Scrum in all different scenarios. Right, I think people should be aware of what are the limitations of the industry, what they want to apply those scenarios in. Right, I do not know whether Scrum really works in sales or not. Right, but people are doing it. So that's the I think the limitations.
See, I think if we kind of rather than if I just say waterfall is certain things have to be done in a serial manner.
Right.
It's a linear. Right. After step one, step two. After step two, step three.
Right.
That is true.
Yes.
Okay. There is no way I can put my shirt and then wear my underwear.
Yes.
Technology like that has not been yet invented, unless you are Superman.
Right. So I think we have a conclusion here that don't.
I think we discussed why Agile is important and why should we choose Agile. And, do we have points like what all are the limitations in the Agile?
Yeah, of course. Limitations in Agile are quite a few, right? For example, one is to make things Agile, as you have seen in your own organization, it requires a huge cultural change, right? Because people are not used to working like that. Right.
Yeah, my point is once Agile is in place, then what all will be the...
Think about it. The there are other limitations like getting funding, right? Because if you are the it is very difficult to commit to deadlines. Right. Especially in high risk environments, right? Where this is because of Agile, we cannot commit to everything because this is the way we work, right? We cannot commit to you. This timeline will happen, right? Because we will see how it goes. We will see how the features are developed. Some features may take longer than what we predict, and our estimation may not be correct, right? So those negatives exist, but people have to accept those negatives. This is,
but their irony is like startup companies always try to work in an agile model, right? Nowadays. Even though they, in their case, actually the funding is a major aspect. Like investors has to invest only then.
That is all high risk capital. There, the people who are investing in those startups, they already understand that this money is at high risk. This may succeed, this may not succeed. They have already accepted that fact. Right.
Yes.
So 1 out of 10 startups will succeed in their, that is the calculation in the investor's mind already. Right. So that's why they spread their investments. So they have already accepted that, but that does not happen in very large investment organizations, where even you take big companies like Microsoft or AWS, you go and look at their roadmaps, right? They will say feature roadmap for so and so product, say approximately this is the time we will release, and they keep adjusting it. Right now, right. If you are as a customer dependent on that timeline, you have to accept that this timeline is not real, right? They may push it. Next week something happens, they will say, okay, we have to adjust the timeline. Sorry, we cannot meet that date, right? So that is the negative part of Agile. Means the thing is, you can still work with it. It's not life and death issue, right? That is, and you need, of course, to make this.
Yeah.
The customers have to accept that. The organization trying to build that has to accept that this is a given with Agile.
Yeah, that is, I think, with an accepted risk, because the other side also there, like if we commit something and there is chance, like we may not deliver all the things that we committed. And the reverse case also, if we commit something in some situation, probably we can deliver more than what we committed.
Yes, yes. So that's what means, if you have a certain requirement for deadlines, things like compliance requirements, there is no way you have to work backward from the deadline. He says, we have to make this thing work, whether we do agile or waterfall. This is not acceptable. The timeline is committed. Right? So that is the and plus, people, once they get used to this whole flexible timeline, now you force the timeline on them, it becomes difficult to manage both sides of the behavior. I says, when do I commit to timeline? When I do not commit to timeline? When do I have the flexibility? When I don't have the flexibility? So, as all of you probably experienced now, is that invariably we are doing somewhere in the middle, right?
Yeah.
We are doing the agile in the waterfall way, right? because we know once something is committed, we have to deliver. We just divide it into sprints and to do it.
Right.
So I think that's a good conclusion. Maybe I do not know if you guys got something new out of it, but I understood what the meaning now for waterfall is, and why you should choose to do waterfall, and why you should choose to do agile, especially for software projects, and why people should accept the things which will come along with agile. Any last comments from anybody? We are right on the dot at 10 o'clock. Okay, so thank you everyone for listening and subscribing to our channel and listening to our conversations. Please give us your feedback and see you next time.